If your colony has outgrown and soiled its test tube, perhaps we can keep them in an open test tube in the future. This is a velvet tree ant colony with hundreds of workers. Normally, it would be a bad decision to open this test tube, so I'm going to show you a trick that we can use in this case. We can temporarily use a simple container box for this, but the best will be the formicarium, I will tell you why later. As a first step, coat the top of the box with anti-escape oil. This will prevent the ants from escaping. Apply thinly, otherwise the oil will run down the side of the box and the ants will stick in it. Place the colony inside and carefully open the test tube inside the box. The ants immediately escape, but they won't be able to get out of the box because of the escape prevention. It's much easier to feed such a large colony here than in an overcrowded test tube. In addition, the ants have more space here and they can react if the water in the test tube breaks through the cotton wool. In a closed test tube, the water could flood in the ants, however, in this free-range housing, the entire colony can escape from the test tube. Wrap a clean test tube setup with aluminium foil to make it dark. Put this into the box and the ants will move into this one later from the old and dirty test tube. They do it because they feel the darker test tube more safety and comfortable. Of course, sometimes we can hurry things up if we tip them out from the previous test tube, but this species defends itself with formic acid during stress, so we don't want so many workers to commit suicide. Carefully remove the pieces of cotton wool. The ants immediately go to the honey, they really needed food already. Let's also throw in a few pieces of mealworms to give them protein. We can see the workers not really successful on the escape prevent oil, since their legs can't stick to the oily surface. A few days later, the ants moved into the new test tube, so we can remove the dirty one. Of course, let's make sure that the remaining workers are also removed from it. If we take a closer look, we can see that they moved all the brood with eggs and larvae to the new test tube. So this is a really effective and gentle method for moving a colony. The ants did it themselves, we just need to give them the ideal conditions. Now for the cons. The anti-escape layer will disappear from the walls of the box in a few weeks. It evaporates, maybe the ants load it with more solid particles so they can climb up, or they somehow fight their way through it. So from time to time, we should put some fresh oil on it, and it could be a good idea to close the container. But now, we have to talk about another problem. If there isn't enough ventilation in the box, the colony inside can commit suicide with formic acid under stress, or can suffocate without enough fresh air. Better ventilation or some soil could reduce the risk of this, but the best final solution if we keep the ants in a formicarium, where the ventilation is adequate and we also have a better insight into the process in the nest than in a test tube. So if we already have a larger formicarium, we can use its arena part just like the box shown earlier. But first, we have to close the nest part to prevent the ants to move into the nest part too soon. Then put the test tube in the arena part. We can use test tube holder to prevent its rolling. Then open the test tube and let the scouts out. From now on, put the food into the arena instead of the test tube. We can even feed them in small bowls or even just to the bottom of the formicarium, as acrylic arenas are easy to clean. From now on, we can offer the ants a variety of food. Moreover, we can also gradually get them used to looking for food themselves. If the test tube gets dirty or dries out over time, we can put another clean test tube in the arena next to it, and in most cases, the ants will relocate on their own within a few days. If this doesn't happen, then just take out the old test tube, carefully sprinkle in the ants, so they will move into the clean test tube without any other option. But with this method, we could lose some brood, because some of the eggs and larvae will stick into the test tube, so we have to put them back carefully with a brush. So better if the ants move by themselves. Due to the larger space and more food, the number of individuals in our colony multiplies in a few weeks or a few months depending on the species. When they have better control of the area and quickly find food, it is time to open the nest part of the formicarium for the ants. Important to wait until they have enough workers, because if we let them in too early, the colony could move in, but maybe they won't have enough workers to go out searching for food. It could emerge a crisis in the colony because they don't have enough food to raise workers, but even don't have enough workers to find enough food. The number of workers recommended to open the nest varies by species. For a smaller species, 30 to 50 workers may be needed, but for a larger species, even 20 may be enough. After we open the nest part, the scouts will map their new territory. If they find it suitable, the whole colony will move in. This can take days, depending on the number of workers. A larger colony has more scouts, so it can find a new place faster and they can move faster. After that, we just have to feed and water them, so we can observe as they rise more and more workers and our ant society grows up slowly. Don't forget to like and subscribe and hit the bell icon. Click for the next episode.